will be equal to T1. You have two equations. So what is the order of the equation here? It's a differential equation, not a differential equation, right?
Yes, sir.
So what is the order of the equation?
We can say
two.
It's a second order equation, right? What is the independent variable here?
R.
What is the dependent variable here?
Temperature.
Temperature is the dependent variable. So you have a second order ordinary differential equation where R is the independent variable and temperature is the dependent variable. So for a second order equation, how many boundary conditions do you need? In order to solve second order ordinary differential equation, how many boundary conditions do you need?
Two
boundary conditions you need, and I have given you two boundary conditions, right? So can I get the temperature profile now from this equation? Will you be able to really evaluate the temperature profile? How will you do that? Anybody?
Sir, what did you say in the last line? I could not hear it.
I have a second order ordinary differential equation, right? With two boundary conditions. So how do I solve it? The second order boundary, so dependent variable is temperature and independent variable is
R,
radius, right?
So
how do I solve this differential equation? If I solve this differential equation, what should I get? Anybody?
We will get T as a function of R.
Right, that is called temperature profile. If you get any variable, temperature, velocity, okay, or concentration, any variable as a function of space, that is what is called temperature profile. Right? Say suppose you every day you see weather report across India, what is the temperature, what is the amount of rainfall. So these are all variables, dependent variables. Temperature, rainfall, these are all dependent variables. And across the space, what you get the temperature contour or the temperature profile. So if you solve this equation, you are going to get the temperature profile across the wire. This is a one-dimensional equation, second order one-dimensional ordinary differential equation. And that ordinary differential equation has the independent variable of R and dependent variable of T. If you solve this equation, you will get the temperature profile across the wire. And in order to solve this equation, you need two boundary conditions, correct? And then you have two boundary conditions. This type of boundary condition is called a Neumann boundary condition. And this type of boundary condition is called a Dirichlet boundary condition. So at R equal to zero, you have the gradient of temperature to be zero. At R equal to R1, you have the temperature to be T1. Now, what you need to do, you need to integrate, right? Integrate this equation.
Yes, sir.
Considering G to be constant. So can you integrate quickly and come up with the profile? What is the temperature profile?
Yes, sir. Just a minute, sir.
So you have to do integration twice, right? First take this g by k that you take to the right hand side. and then you have to multiply by R, right?
Yes, sir. Sir, first, you have to give the final equation.
First is what is dt by dr?
So dt by dr equals to constant minus g dot r square by 2 upon kr.
Yes. Now you know at r equal to 0, dt by dr equal to 0, right?
R equal to, yes, sir.
So what is c1?
R g dot r square by 2 at
r d r square
r square by 2 into g dot should be c1. Yes sir, r square is there.
There was one r in the left hand side here. This r is also there. Did you consider this?
The c1 is 0
by 2.
Yes, c1 is 0. Very correct. So then what is dt by dr?
Okay, ha, yes sir. Is it
minus g dot r by 2k?
Yes.
G dot
r by 2.
Correct. Now integrate once again. So what is the temperature profile coming now for the wire?
Minus g dot r square by 4k plus c.
So constant, you can get rid of the constant by enforcing this boundary condition. T at r1 equal to t1.
Yes, sir. Minus g dot r square by 4k, and we have to implement.
Yes, so what is the profile coming? What is t is a function of r coming? Is equal to
T1 plus G dot R1 square minus R square by 4.
Very nice. G dot by 4K. K you are missing.
Yes, the 4K into R1 square minus R. Yes.
R1 square minus R. Very nice. R so you square. See that? R square, right. Correct. Yeah. So this is your temperature profile, correct?
Yes.
Now this is temperature profile in which place? This is the temperature profile in which place? Can anybody tell me? This is the temperature profile in this where, right? So I have put this boundary and that boundary, correct? This is the temperature profile here, right? In this where. So now how do you go about the temperature profile for this shell, which is the blue part? For this blue part, how will you go about the shell? Anybody?
Sir, first you will find out dt by dr at r1.
Yes, what will happen to this equation?
Sir, we have to find two boundary conditions for that profile also, sir.
Correct, but what will the equation will remain same or different?
No, sir, it will be different. First, to find boundary conditions, we will substitute r1 in this equation, sir. So we can
asking that differential equation will remain same or the differential equation will change?
No, sir, we have to integrate this equation only, but only boundary conditions will change, sir.
Yes, but if you integrate this equation, will you carry forward the g dot? G dot is the heat that you are generating in this wire, right?
Yes, sir.
G dot you are not generating here. There is no current here. So for the equation of the coating, this equation for this coating, which is called ceramic here, this part, there is no current, right? And there is no G dot, correct?
Yes, sir.
So this G dot will be zero for the ceramic wire. This G dot will only be true for the copper wire. Right?
Yes, sir.
Rest remains same. So what will be your equation? Your equation will be K, but K will be for this K ceramic, 1 by R ddr, R dt dr equal to zero. Now, what will be the two boundary conditions here? Anybody, what will be the two boundary conditions here? What is the boundary condition here for that equation? At r equal to r1, what will be the temperature?
T1.
This I have already defined in the previous case, right? And at r equal to r2, what will be the temperature? That is given already, 45, right?
45.
Right, that we can say as T2. So I have to essentially now integrate the equation. What? Which equation I have to integrate? I have to integrate the equation now that K into 1 by R, sorry, 1 by R T dr of R delta T by R, sorry, dt by dr by dr is equal to 0. Can you quickly integrate and let me know what is the temperature profile coming with the boundary condition? What? The T equal to R1, T at R1 is what? Is T1, and T at R2 is T2. Which is equal to 45 degrees. What is the profile you are getting? What is TR here? Final level. Anybody could crack it? Simple integration, right? Why is it taking so much of time? Yes, anybody could integrate? Integration is taking so much of time. What is TR? Mohit, did you get TR?
Sir, just a second, sir. I'm calculating. Just a second. Okay. It's a 2-degree equation, right? So.
It's a what is that? It is just a kind of second order equation, right?
Second order equation, yeah.
So first this will be C1, right? And then C1 by R dt by dr. It's straightforward, right? So yeah, dr, so C1 by R, dr by R and dt. So T2 minus T1 ln R2 by R1, right? Straightforward, no?
Yes, sir.
So what is TR?
I think I made some mistake. I think, yeah, that's the mistake. That's why I got stuck. Sir, ln of R, right? That's the equation, right?
So what is the equation? Finally, enforce boundary conditions and let me know what is the equation.
Yes, sir.
Arpit, are you there? Arpit? Asif, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, could you integrate?
Yes, sir. T minus T1 is equal to C1 log R upon R1.
Log R upon R1. So you have two boundary conditions, no?
Yes, sir.
What is your first? After the integration, what is with the constant, what is your equation? So you have to integrate twice, right?
Yes, sir. First, it is zero, so we can write their constant.
Okay.
Then we will divide by C1 by R, then dr by R integration is log R.
Okay.
And boundary conditions like at R1, we have at R1 and then R. Then we have log R by R1.
Yes. So then what is tr coming? Can you prompt me? TR is equal to T1, TI, rather TI, internal, or T1. Let me write T1 because we are following T1 plus.
Log R upon R1.
No, I am having ln R by R1 divided by ln R1 by R2, R2 by R1. Okay.
R2 by R1. Sir, for also there will be term of R square by 4
into T2 minus T. Okay, this is the solution that I have here. I'm not sure whether it is correct or not.
Okay, sir. Sir, was there a term of R square by 4 or does it get like...
Why R square will come here? See, it's very straightforward. No, say suppose this will go to 0, right? So when you do ddr, r of dt by dr becomes c1. Now dt by dr equal to c1 by r. So you have to integrate. So dt is equal to c1 dr by r. Right? So c1 ln r plus c2. Now at t equal to t1, you have R equal to R1 at T equal to T1 and R equal to R2, you have T equal to T2. If you enforce these two boundary conditions, you eliminate C1, C2, and from there you get this expression.
Yes, sir, it is coming.
Yes, sir, this is like, actually, okay, huh. C1 ln R plus C2 is the, like, and we get the... Okay.
Yes. Yes. So all of you have obtained this?
Yes, sir.
So now we have a profile for this and we have a profile for that. Let us go back to the problem and let us once again see. You know, can anybody read this again, once again? Quickly. Yes, read for me loudly. I want to hear. Somebody is reading. Abhijit, are you there, Abhijit? Abhijit Tapas.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Can you please read for me?
Yes, sir.
Hmm.
Consider a long resistance wire of radius R1 is equal to 0.2 centimeter and thermal conductivity K is equal to 12 watt per meter per degree Celsius, in which heat is generated uniformly as a result of resistance heating at a constant rate of G dot is equal to 50 watt per centimeter cube. The wire is embedded in a 0.5 centimeter thick layer of ceramic whose thermal conductivity is K is equal to 1.2 watt per meter degree Celsius. If the outer surface temperature of the ceramic layer is measured to be TS is equal to 45 degrees Celsius, determine the temperatures of the center of the resistance of the wire and the interface of the wire and the ceramic layer under steady conditions. Assumptions.
Correct. So you have now understood, like, you know, how to calculate inside the wire and how to calculate outside the wire in the ceramic.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Right? Now what should we do in this situation? What is the question? What I need to determine?
We need to determine the temperature of center of wire and the interface of
ceramic. And the interface, correct?
Yes, sir.
So what is the temperature at the interface, of what should I get? So what I assume that this wire, whatever amount heat is generated and that is being transmitted. So interface temperature, say I have obtained two equations, correct? I have obtained from the ceramic side, I have obtained, this is my T1, right? And yes, from the other expression, I have obtained my final A as T1, right?
Yes, sir.
This is from the other side. So these two T1 should be equal?
Yes, sir.
So if I equate these two temperatures, then what happens? Then these two equations I can employ in order to determine what?
In order to determine the temperature of center, sir.
Correct. So let us go for it. Let us do it. What is it? How is it coming there?
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Yeah. Go ahead. What is the interface temperature now? You have all the other parameters given. So here you have to use a trick that, you know, I just, you know, let you know this part, that how do I obtain the interface temperature? So what I have to do, I have to use a trick. What is that trick? That minus K, okay, dT by dR, which is my copper wire, right? This is evaluated at R1. This is for my copper part, right? Is equal to minus, say, suppose this is KC, copper part, right? Now this is equal to minus K. This is my ceramic part, insulation part, is equal to dT by dR, okay, which is again at R1, right? So what am I saying? That the temperature gradient in the copper side, the heat conduction, whatever heat is being conducted up to this point, that is taken up here. So, you know, the rate of heat transfer, the interface temperature, you know, you are getting what? You are telling that the Q dot, the rate of heat transfer, to be same, whatever heat is coming and that is being transmitted into the other part, right? Now this T is what? This is the temperature profile is we are going to use this particular temperature profile, right? So from there I have to obtain dT by dR. And this T is what? This T I have to use for this temperature profile. So what will be the equation that I'll be getting here? Can anybody tell me quickly? From if I take dT by dR from here, what am I supposed to get? Quickly, somebody. Yes, anybody is there who can tell me?
Minus G dot R by 2K.
Very good. Minus G dot R by 2K, right? So I have minus G dot R by 2K. This is minus G dot R or R1?
Here R1, sir.
Yes. R1 by 2, correct? And then that is equal to, you know, if I take a derivative of this, what should I get? This is equal to minus K.
Oh, 1 by R.
1 by R, very nice. 1 by R1.
Yeah, 1 by R1. And the log terms, that is ln of...
TS minus T1, well, that means T2 minus T1.
T2 minus T1.
Divided by ln?
R2.
R2 by R1, right?
R2 by R1.
Correct?
Yes, sir.
So now can I obtain what is T1? Because T2 has been given. I know R1, R2, I know G dot, I know K ceramic, or K insulation or K ceramic. So can I obtain what is T2? What is T1? Because T2 is given to me 45 degree, correct? What is the interface temperature? Could you calculate? Be very careful that you know you are given 50, sorry, watt per centimeter cube. So as per this, what is my T1 coming out to be? G dot R1 square by 2KC ln R2 by R1 plus T2. Yes.
I think, sir, T2 minus this term, it will come out.
How much is coming, temperature?
So 44.999.
No.
Sir, 150 degrees Celsius.
150 degrees centigrade. Yes, that is correct. Well, how much is R2? How much is R2? The person who got 150, who got 150? I'm unable to see the name.
Sir, I.
Harsh, right?
Yes.
What is R2?
0.2 plus 0.5 thickness.
So how much is that?
0.7 centimeter.
Centimeter, 0.007 meter, okay?
Yes.
What is R1?
0.002.
Right, even you made two mistakes and then that actually helped you in getting a correct result, right? Be very careful about units. What is G dot?
G dot, 50 watt per centimeter. Sir, I have calculated it in all in meter.
Yes, but how much is that? G dot?
50 watt per centimeter.
In SI?
Divided by 10 to the power minus 6.
So 50 into 10 to the power 6 watt per meter cube, right?
Yes.
What is R1 square?
0.2 square into 10 to the power minus 10 to the power minus 4.
Yes, 0.002. 0.002 whole square, right?
Yes.
What is KC here?
1.2 watt per meter Kelvin.
Meter degree centigrade, right? Yeah. So if you add all of them, it is coming out to be 149.4 to be precise. And what is T2 here?
T2 is
45
degrees Celsius.
Correct. So what is the interface temperature that you obtain? So if T45, if it is generating 40 watt per meter cube heat, outside temperature of the wire is 45, but inside temperature is how much? Here, what is the temperature then?
So is it 149?
Yeah, it is 149.4 or 150 degrees centigrade. So at this place, you have about 150 degrees centigrade temperature, right?
Yes.
Now question is there, what is the temperature here? How will you obtain? So you already know T1, right? What is T1?
149.4.
Right. Then what is at R equal to 0?
We will calculate it.
Quickly calculate karo. Kitna aata hai?
So 153 degrees centigrade.
Right. So it is. So you see that at the center you have 153 degrees centigrade. At this juncture you have 150 degrees centigrade, and outside you have 45. So across a thermal conductor, you don't have much of drop. Only two degree drop. So if I really look at this particular equation, so since this K is very high, this DTDR is very low in the metal. Whereas in case of an insulator, since this K is very, very low, the DTDR is very high. So across this, you may see that the drop is about, say this is 45 and this is 150. Right? So the question that Hemant asks, sir, what is steady state? Steady state is this, that whatever heat I am receiving, if I am able to transmit or transfer, that is a steady state situation. Say suppose your body temperature is maintained at 98.6. You know, every corner of your body, you know, lot of heat is generated, lot of reactions are going on, lot of activities are going on, correct? But at the end of the day, whatever heat is generated, that heat is transferred somewhere, distributed somewhere, so that when you measure the temperature, repeatedly if you measure the temperature, you get a temperature which is 98.6. So in order to really, in a dynamical process, a process where things are changing, fluctuating, if you don't, really have a parameter changing, okay, even if the process is in a dynamical process, you can really see that these electrons are flowing from the molecular level. The electrons are flowing through the wire, right? You know, the joule heating is taking place. But even in that situation, after a time, you will find that central temperature is at 150. You know, this junction temperature will be at, this is 152, this is at 150. And outside temperature will be at 45. And you can maintain this temperature without fluctuating it with respect to time. This is what is called steady state. Okay, so could I answer your question, Hemant?
Yes, sir. But I was thinking that when heat, there are molecules around it. When heat comes to them, they absorb some part of it for some period of time, and then they dissipate some of it. So I was asking that how that happens, means what molecule does that, it absorbs some part then dissipates, why don't it keep on absorbing and destroy itself, something like that.
See, when it is absorbing means what? There is an electronic transition taking place, otherwise there is no absorption, right? So those who have got very huge band gap, they don't really respond to any absorption, correct? So suppose the electrical insulators, you know, non-conductors, they don't undergo any electronic transition, so they don't essentially absorb anything. Absorption is associated with one energy, one particle is going to the excited state. Now, once it is in the excited state, you know, the absorption happens. Once it comes back to the ground state, it releases the energy. Okay?
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
And if it continuously happening, then it is attracting some energy and it is releasing some energy. So then, you know, if it keeps happening, if I keep shining a light, and then if it keeps happening again and again, so that is in a steady state.
Okay, right? Sir. It's clear.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah. Thank you. So let us move to the last problem. I think, you know, the if I do problem 1 and 5, I think we'll be able to do all the problems. You will be able to really do all the problems. So let us look at problem number 5. Now, Hemant, can you read it for me?
Yes, sir. Steam in a heating engine flows through tubes whose outer diameter is 3 cm and whose walls are maintained at the temperature of 120 degrees Celsius. Circular aluminum fins with K equal to 180 watt per meter degrees Celsius of outer diameter equal to 6 cm and constant thickness 2 millimeter are attached to the tube. The space between the fins is 3 mm. And thus there are 200 fins per meter length of the tube. Heat is transferred to the surrounding air at T infinity 25 degrees Celsius with a combined heat transfer coefficient of 60 watt per meter square degrees Celsius. Determine the increase in heat transfer from the tube per meter of its length as a result of adding fins.
Right. So here, what is the mode of heat transfer?
Conduction.
Yes. Who is that? Somebody told. Who is that? What did you tell? Please repeat. You are correct. That's why I'm asking. Hello. Please repeat. Conduction is not correct.
Convection,
right? Yes. So, and what is the rule for convection of heat transfer? Convective heat transfer. What is the formula? What is the law that we use?
Sir, Q dash equal to H A T minus T F.
What is that law called? The name of the law is Newton's law of cooling. Okay. The name of the law is Newton's law of cooling, right? So we yes. consider to be what? We consider that rate of heat transfer is equal to H, which is called the heat transfer coefficient, A into say T surface minus T infinity or delta T, right? So here you are given a fin. See, you know, there are many things that are happening in this fin. So suppose this is the tube of a shell and tube heat exchanger through which a hot fluid is flowing, and you are blowing air around it, through which what you are doing, you are cooling down. Now you have two situations embedded inside. One, it is only the tube, or you have put some, you know, fins around it so that the heat transfer increases. Now, my question is that if I put fin, why the convective heat transfer? These are called fins, by the way. Fins means, you know, shark fins are there, no? You know, that is what is typically called a fin. Fin means an extended surface. So, these things are called fins, you know, these discs, circular discs are called fins. So, if I really don't put these fins, then it is a kind of cylindrical tube. But if I put a fin, what am I changing here in this situation? If this tube is embedded with these fins, what is changing in this equation? What is changing?
Sure, area.
Area is changing, right? So I have a situation where A is without fin, and I have a situation where A is with the fins. Am I correct? So my question, the first question is that without fin, what will be your heat transfer, rate of heat transfer? Can you calculate? How will you calculate? What is the heat transfer coefficient given? Is it given? What is the heat transfer coefficient?
60 watt per meter square.
Yes. So you have 60 watt per meter square degree centigrade, right? What is the temperature difference? What is the inside temperature? Wall temperature, rather. What is the wall temperature?
One twenty.
120 degree centigrade. Very nice. And what is the outside temperature?
25
degrees. So what is delta T? 95. Yeah, 120 minus 25, that is 95, right? Now, what is area without fin? So the question that has been asked, that if I add this fin, so determine the increase in the heat transfer from the tube per meter length, per meter of its length, as a result of adding the fins. So I have to first calculate, if I don't have the fin, only this cylinder, what is the rate of heat transfer? Then I have to really calculate addition of the fins, what is the change in the area, right? And then from these two, we have to compare that, what is the addition in the, what is the difference? Is it clear? So first let us calculate that if it is like this only, if you don't have these three disks, then how, what is the heat transfer, rate of heat transfer from the cylinder? What is the area of the cylinder? What is the formula of an area of a cylinder?
2 pi RL.
2 pi RL.
2 pi RL.
Pi DL.
Temperature difference.
Kitna aa raha hai?
Sorry, sir. I will calculate. Sir, for 1 meter, we have to take, sir?
Yes. Per meter likha hua hai na?
So per meter area would be 0.188. So 0.188. That is 0.1.
What is D?
D is 3 centimeters.
Sir, 0.09.
Yes, 0.095 meters square. Yes. Always careful, you know, engineering calculations, you have to be very, very careful. This is where the blunders are made. 1.5, 2 millimeter, 3 millimeter, 3 centimeter. If you don't convert them to SI units, and you know, if you start playing the way that you played during the JE, it's gone. JE is more of a conceptual exam where, you know, accuracy is not that important. You know, here accuracy is, you have to be, you know, dead accurate. Otherwise, you know, there'll be errors. So yes, method is very, very important. So what is Q? How much is Q dot?
536.94.
Very nice.
536.94.
Correct. Ho gaya. Now, how many fins are there per meter?
200.
So there are 200 fins per meter, right? Now you have to calculate the area with the fins. How will you do that?
We will add the area of that.
Karo, kitna aaya area?
Minus that.
Hey. So what is the area with fin? What is the area of a single fin? How are you calculating the area of a single fin?
Pi D2 minus D1 into thickness.
Pi?
D2 minus D1 into thickness, that will be cylindrical part.
No, that is only this part, right?
Yes, sir, outer surface part.
But into then you have
thickness. You will thickness that surface will come in.
No,
then
you have two surfaces, no? Top and bottom.
Yes, sir. Twice time those, and then surface area of cylinder.
What is that for the top? What is that? So pi R2 square minus R1 square, correct?
Yes, sir. Yes.
That is the top area. Now, if you multiply by twice, then you get the for one, and then you add to that 2 pi RL, right? the area at the side. So you have a top side, you have a top surface, you have a side surface, you have a bottom surface. You have to add all three area. How much is it coming for a single pin? कितना लग रहा है एरिया कितना है कितना टाइम लग रहा है कैलकुलेट करने में Yes, कितना है एरिया जल्दी से बोलिए
-4
ये क्या है एरिया what is R2 you have taken
सर 0.8632 मीटर स्क्वायर
0.86 तो नहीं है डबल हो गया मेरा कैलकुलेशन बोल रहा है 0.0046 मीटर स्क्वायर हाउ मच यू हैव टेकन R2
3 सेंटीमीटर
हां दैट मींस 0.03 मीटर ओके
व्हाट
इज R1
1.5 सेंटीमीटर
So 0.015 meter, right? What is L?
Sir, it's 200 minus that first.
What is T? What is T?
2 mm, sir.
So that means how many meter?
2 × 10⁻³ × 200.
Correct. Not 200. You don't take 200 there. Per, you have to first calculate per fin. Don't.
Okay, sir.
Multiply 200 here. Then you have to multiply 200 and everywhere. First, you calculate for a single fin what is the area.
Yes, sir.
What is the area for a single fin?
Sir, 0.023.
No.
0.04.
Yes, somehow 0. My number is 0.0046. Anyways, now once you have the area, so how do you calculate the rate of heat transfer? It is Q equal to HA delta T, correct? Now for a single meter length, how will you calculate the total rate of heat transfer? So you have these 200 fins, right? Now, if you have 200 fins, that means you also have this 200 without fins, cylinders, that is actually composing your 1 meter area, 1 meter length. So you have to keep adding them, you know, see this plus this, you have to repeat 200 times, you know, heat transfer through this, heat transfer through this, you know, this is one unit and you repeat them 200 times to get the total area. So you calculate the rate of heat transfer from this, rate of heat transfer from this, and then you know you multiply by 200 per unit for a single meter to get the what is the total rate of heat transfer, and then you compare with the previous one which is unfinned. Am I clear? Did you get it? How to do that? Somebody should tell me yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, great. So you have 5 problems. Okay, so you do it. You know, it's a little bit, you know, some of the lectures that are coming there, some parts are from there also. So you look at the books and then do it, and we'll take up those problems as we progress. Anyway, you attempt these problems, this will be very, very interesting. Right, take care then, you know, see you on Monday. And you have any questions?